Hi everyone, New York Times bestselling author Jamie Brumfield, and welcome back to my channel. We are going to talk about our daily self-help, coaching, personal growth, and personal development topic today. And today we're going to talk about how to be more confident. Now, being confident is a tricky, tricky, tricky thing because you can be confident in some things and not confident in others. And it's really just about changing a mindset. They say a lot of times being confident is about being faking it until you make it. Sometimes you have to feel like you have to put forward a confident air about yourself, and you may not feel inside as confident as you feel as you're projecting outward. And that happens, especially if you're in uncharted territory or uncharted waters. You haven't been here before. You're learning something. That confidence can sway, but you still need to exude that confidence. There is a tricky line between confidence and being arrogant. So confidence is about exuding that or putting forward the vibe that you've got this kind of thing. Whereas being arrogant is putting forward the vibe that you know everything and you've got this. That comes into play with the whole you've got it vibe, but it comes across more abrasive, perhaps is the word to use, or it just comes across as being unlikable. If you missed our how to be likable video, you want to be genuine. You want to, you know, check out the how to be likable video and kind of see how these two can kind of correlate together. Confidence is important. Sometimes you have to put forward more confidence than you might be feeling inside, but you'll find as you continue to get better at something, that confidence will continue to grow naturally. So if you are doing something that you is new to you, just keep in mind that sometimes putting forward that confident air can be a benefit to you, and it can help you as you're continuing to learn the process. So here are some tips that I've got on how to be confident. And as I'm going through these tips, definitely let me know in the comment section below if there is one of these tips that you'd like a more in-depth video on that specific tip, that specific topic, and I can go ahead and add it to my content list. So give me a heads up down below if there's something you'd like to hear more about. So number one, start by being positive. Being positive is super important. I talk about being positive in many of my videos, just like I talked about the how to be likable video. I talked about how being positive can create be the likability factor. So being positive is super important. If you're negative, it's hard to be confident in something. It's hard to come across as being confident. It's hard to feel it inside, and it's hard to exude that or put that out to others to create the vibe that you are confident. So if you're finding yourself being negative, find ways to be more positive. Being positive is the process of, you know, looking at things optimistically. You don't have to look at it where you're in the dream realm where, you know, everything's beautiful roses, because life isn't beautiful roses. But finding something positive, even in the worst case scenarios, really has a big impact on confidence, likability, and so many other things, other areas in your life. So positivity is super important. Also, if you believe in the law of attraction, then it's about putting positivity out into the world, being positive and being open to receiving the positivity that comes back. If you're putting negativity out into the world, you're attracting negativity. What you put out is what you're attracting. So if you want to attract that positivity, then you want to continue to work on being positive. Number two, celebrate and take pride in your achievements. It's okay to celebrate and take pride in your achievements. My coaching clients always have a success celebration plan where they go ahead and they've achieved something, whether it's big, medium, or small, and they've got lists of what they can do to celebrate that. Celebrate your achievements. Don't be afraid to mention your achievements, because that's not being arrogant. That's just saying, hey, I did achieve this. It's a fact. It's not going to, unless you're rubbing it in, or unless you're repeating it over and over again, unless you're, you know, basically just using that as your, you know, vibe going forward, if you're just, you know, celebrating your achievements moving forward and picking another goal to start working on and celebrating those achievements, that's going to create confidence for you. And it's also going to give that vibe of confidence because you know you're on the right path and it's good. It's good. So celebrate and take pride in your achievements. It's okay to take pride in your achievements and celebrate them. And just, you don't want to go overboard and constantly push it into, you know, like being a bragging about your achievements or being arrogant. It's more about, hey, I'm celebrating my achievements. I've done a good job. I'm going to celebrate this. Hey, friends, look what I did. I am so excited. And then move on to the next thing. Celebrate with them for a minute and then move on to the next thing and continue to work towards gaining the skills and the knowledge that you need in that area to become more confident. So you're building up, you know, the layers of confidence. And number three, overcome negative self-talk. I'm going to do a video on mindset reframe, but overcoming negative self-talk can be really difficult because we don't realize we're doing it. So it's really important to, if you feel like there's an inner voice inside that's keeping you from being confident, it's probably that negative self-talk that's constantly talking in your subconscious mind saying, oh, I'm not good enough, or you're not doing that right, that kind of thing. And that stems from things all the way back to childhood sometimes, or even further back. So, you know, it's just about managing that negative self-talk. I used to have a critic in my head, and that critic used to always literally, I used to feel like I wasn't worthy of my success, or I wasn't worthy of the things that I was accomplishing. I wasn't worthy of this. And there were reasons for that. And that negative critic, I used hypnotherapy to basically give her the boot. And it's a different process with hypnotherapy because you're using visual pictures in your mind to kind of work through what processes or what issues that you're trying to deal with. But once I eliminated her influence over me, that negative critic, that negative self-talk, once I eliminated that influence over me, it was easier to exude confidence because I was no longer hearing in the back of my head that I was not good enough. And a lot of us feel that way. It's more common than you realize. So if you feel like you're having negative self-talk, then, you know, you want to eliminate that. If you want a deeper video on that, on how to do that, let me know in the comment section below. So the next one is have a growth mindset. Focus in on, and that's number four, focus in on, you know, growing every day, advancing and achieving every day and continuing to grow. And it's okay to fail. Failure is okay. Confident people fail all the time. Failure means that you're trying. If you don't fail, you haven't tried. Failure means that you are moving forward. You have that growth mindset. But you're allowing yourself to, you know, learn the lesson that you need to learn from the failure and then try again. But this time, try with the lesson that you just learned to see if the little changes that you can make a difference in that growth. And every day, work on growing and advancing towards your achievements, towards your goal. Keep that success plan in mind. I do talk about an ROI, getting a return on your investment. I'm going to talk a little bit more on this series about how to focus in on time management and creating that growth mindset. So let me know in the comment section below if you'd like to see that sooner than when it's planned. Then number five is body language. Your body language can give the impression that you're confident. It can also give the impression that you don't believe in yourself or you're not confident. So make sure that your body language is actually putting out the vibe that you want it to put out. Be open. Don't be closed in. Be open. Have that confidence. Stand up tall. Have those shoulders straight up. Those kind of things, smile, those kind of things can help with body language to give the vibe that you're confident. You may not be feeling it inside, but keeping the focus on looking confident on the outside can make a big difference in creating that confident vibe but also it can, it does it subconsciously. So you're not saying I'm confident, I'm, you know, you're exuding it, and it's hitting people on a subconscious level. Hey, this person knows what they're talking about, or they're confident. They're either growing in their position, or they're very successful, and they've got something, they've got that confidence that you can feel off of them. It's a subconscious thing, but body language is super important when it comes to growing that confident vibe. Number six, love yourself. That's so important. You gotta love yourself. You gotta love yourself. It's so easy to fall into the ideal that we're not good enough, or our self-worth is just down, or we create limiting beliefs that create negativity inside, and that negativity can come out in your confidence. So you gotta love yourself. Love your good, love your bad, love, you know, your failures, love your successes. Everything that you do, you're moving towards that end goal of success, right? And you're gonna have ups and downs. Life is like this. This is just the way life goes. It's got ebbs and flows. And you got to love yourself even in the hard times, because we're going to have them. We have them. So love yourself. That's super important in creating that confident vibe. Number seven, be here now. Be present. Be in the moment. Be present. If you're focusing on what's going on around you, you're just giving off that vibe that you're confident. You're focused in on finding success in the moment. And that is really a very powerful confidence tool, but it's also a very powerful forward momentum tool. Be focused on the moment. Be there. Be present. And you will find that this creates confidence, a confident vibe, without you even trying, because you're just there. You're present and you're focused and you're determined, and your mind isn't over here or over there. Or you're not paying attention. Those kind of things, those can give off subconscious clues that you're not confident, or you just don't care. Those kind of things, it can give those clues or those hints off subconsciously. And then that gives the vibe that you're not a confident person. So be here, be present, be now, be there. Number eight, identify what you are not confident in, and then learn new skills that will make you more confident. This is probably your most powerful tool, because confidence comes with experience. So if you know you're not confident in this area, then learn what you need to build those skills to become more confident. Confidence comes with experience. Sometimes you have to exude that confident vibe without the experience, but sometimes just creating that confident vibe is about knowing your stuff, being confident and knowing your stuff. So learn the skills that you need to improve the areas that you're not confident in. And number nine, identify what you are confident in and continue to show those to the world. Number 10, fake it till you feel it. And that's just really putting forward that confidence vibe that I've been talking about this whole time. Look, confidence comes with experience. I'm not going to brush that under the table. The more experienced you are, the more confident you're going to get. But sometimes you do have to put forward a confident vibe to be able to learn the skills or move in advance in those ways. So just show, hey, I've got this. And you're learning along the way. Nobody knows everything from the very beginning. Think about us when we were born. We did not know anything. Look at our children. They learn everything from us. So there is that learning curve. And when that learning curve comes into play, especially when you're in business or something like that, fake it till you feel it. Fake it till you feel it. Bonus, stop comparing yourself to others. You are enough. You are valuable. You have so much to offer to this world. If you don't take anything else from this video, you are impressive and you are confident. You just need to stop comparing yourself to other people and realize that you are enough. You are enough. You can do this. You got this. You got this, superstar. That's it for today's video. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm New York Times bestselling author Jamie Brumfield. If you like paranormal romance, paranormal mystery, check out my books on Amazon. Check out all of our Design Your Desired Future videos down below in the video description box. Let me know what you would like to see in our next video regarding confidence, if you'd like me to delve into one of these even more, or just let me know what you're thinking of this series, or let me know what you'd like to see next in our personal development, personal growth video series. Thanks so much for tuning in. I'll see you soon. Bye.